I don't know how much time it took you to configure your Tmux environment, probably weeks. Maybe this is even the first time you're seeing it. In which case, by the way, I highly recommend catching the basics tutorial up here. This is what Tmux looks like if you're just trying to install it from the source. However, with what I'm about to share today, Tmux can instantly transform from this to this. I even have a small bonus surprise if you wait till the end. Okay, my espresso is ready, let's go. Meet.tmux or oh my Tmux. Not only it comes with a pre-packed Tmux sensible defaults, it's also themed and ready to go with plugins right away. It can show you the battery status, the date, even the weather. But that's not all. You can make it control Spotify. Not sure why, but you can. You can run a Pomodoro cycle or even customize it with your own scripts. More on that a little later. For now, let's take a look at the defaults and the basics that it comes with. So to begin with, you can split your screen vertically or horizontally using the shortcuts S and V, S for split and V for vertical. Moving between panes is pre-configured to use the prefix Control A and Vim arrows AJKL to move up and down. Standard keyboard arrows will work just as well. Another option is showing the time with T. You can move back and forth with the numbered windows 1, 3 and 2 obviously. You can see how the status bar is changing as I move. What's nice here is by default the last window that you visited is already marked in gray, so you can know if prefix A goes back to the last window, you can tell which window was that. If you take a look at the configuration for a moment, you'll notice that there's a default tmux.conf, but there's also tmux.conf local, which is the one that you're supposed to edit as a user. That's where we're going to add the set of plugins that we use, new configurations, and anything that we want to modify in the way we work with Tmux. For example, here's a set of plugins I've set with TPM, the Tmux plugin manager, which by the way comes pre-configured in the .tmux directory. And you can see that adding a plugin is as easy as set -g add plugin and the path of the plugin that you want to install. By default, standard Tmux configurations use B as a prefix, which is not that convenient, and .tmux already comes pre-configured with A, which makes sense if you use your caps lock as control. By the way, that's a huge tip I once got. So caps lock as control and then A makes your life easier. And then it comes pre-packed with not only that, but AA takes you back to the last window, and anything you want to do comes very close to your fingers. You can use prefix equal to equalize your splits and Z to zoom into one of the splits or Z again to come back. M will let you use your mouse, so I can drag back and forth splits with my mouse. Not all that useful if you're a power keyboard user, but sometimes nice to have. And by the way, there's a mark down below to show you that you're actually using a mouse configuration or a mouse mode rather. So your Vim motions are already pre-packed in order for you to be able to move up, down, to the sides using AJKL, which are the Vim motions, so prefix and one of the Vim keys helps you navigate. With prefix C, you can close a window or just use Control D to kill the process like I'm doing here. They both serve the same purpose. And .tmux is already configured to open a new one with the same present working directory you're in. So you can see right now I'm at .files.tmux, and if I open a new split, I'm already there. And by the way, if I jump to my home directory and I try to open a new split, there I am back again at the home directory and not anywhere else. My Tmux is already packed with the ability to scroll up and forth in the history of the terminal. So with prefix and brackets, I can move up and then I start controlling the history instead of using the mouse. It's also pre-configured with having anything that you yank through the history to your clipboard, so you can paste it wherever you want. You can also see that moving back and forth between splits is already marked, kind of highlighted in the screen, with the borders being more thick and maybe colored in blue, depending on the theme that you're using. Opening a new window is done by Control C with the prefix before that, so Control A, Control C opens a new one, and just C will close the window, which is rather nice and convenient to use. If you want to change the size of a split, you can do it with equal or minus to take a split up or down if it's split horizontally. Much like in Vim, Tmux keeps memory of its buffers, and with the prefix NB, you can see the buffers that are currently open. By the way, the buffers video will be linked up here in the window if you want to catch that. So I promised some plugin configuration, so let's go and check that out. Here's a nice example of presenting the weather in the status line in Tmux. Not sure why you'd want that, but sometimes it's nice to know what's going on in terms of weather right from your IDE or whatever terminal application you're running, of course. So this is the configuration for .tmux. You can see a line of configurations structured one after the other. You can see whether I'm synchronized, Pomodoro status, battery percentage, etc., etc. Everything is structured based on left side and right side. We'll be touching the right side, as in the right side of the bar down below on the tmux status page. So I'm going to copy the small script that can fetch the weather from WTTR website. I'm going to copy that small snippet and then place it where I see fit in the line in between other plugins. And so there it goes, next to the Pomodoro status and before the battery status. And once saved, I want to reload the configuration and see the weather below. In order to reload the configuration, I'm going to the prefix and A and then colon source file, and I'll go to the path where my configuration for tmux is sitting. In my case, that would be the homepage .config and tmux. Once reloaded, TPM is reloading everything. It lets you know, and there it is, Camberwell, United Kingdom. The weather is somewhat sunny with 11 degrees. I wouldn't say that's 100% correct, but it's nice to see. Let's circle back to the Pomodoro plugin for a second. If you're unaware of Pomodoro, it's a system that can count minutes of focus time and then gives you a certain break. It basically says that you're more productive when you take certain bouts of time to work and then leave yourself a few minutes to rest. And that's basically what it does within tmux. So tmux can present your Pomodoro. It either works on the default line, that would be, I think, 25 minutes and then 5 minutes break, or you can set your own. Regardless, you can install the plugin, and once you activate it, you can see it's going. So there it is, I've activated with P, and you can see I have 25 minutes next to a tomato, and it'll start counting down as I start working. And like I said, I can also set a custom status, so I can choose something else than the default 25 minutes and the 5 minutes break. And once I set that, Pomodoro will start itself and I'll see the different count of minutes that I've chosen. As you can probably tell, Oh My Tmux can do a lot more than just what you've seen here. I highly recommend that you go check out the basics video for Tmux that I've uploaded somewhere around a month ago. And obviously go check the docs for both Tmux and that project to see what else you can do. See you on the next one.